dawn till twilight, or rather from one night till the other, I had lost myself in that symphony. I came home, and sitting by the fire, I felt I was hungry, yes, very hungry. But now you see how it is here. One is feeling exactly as if one had been to an exhibition of 100 masterpieces, for instance. What does one bring home from such a day? Only a number of rough sketches. Yet there is another thing one brings home, a calm ardor for work. I find it queer that I saw it like this from between the iron bars of a cell. I have a great desire to do the Reaper once again for Mother, for I am persuaded that Mother would understand it, for it is in fact as simple as one of those coarse wood engravings that you find in country almanacs. What a queer thing the touch is, the stroke of the brush, in the open air, exposed to the wind, to the sun, to the curiosity of people. You work as you can, you fill your canvas in. Then, however, you catch the real and essential. That is the most difficult. But when, after a time, you again take up your study and arrange your brushstrokes in the direction of the object, certainly it is more harmonious and pleasant to look at, and you add whatever you have of serenity and cheerfulness. Ah, I shall never be able to convey my impressions of some faces that I've seen here. Certainly this is the road on which there is something new, the road to the south, but men of the north find penetrating it difficult. And already I can see myself in the future, when I shall have had some success, regretting my solitude and my wretchedness here, when I saw the reaper in the field below, between the iron bars of the cell. Misfortune is good for something.